Stephen.
Yeah.
How was it?
Thanks for the message, it's really sweet. Okay. Yeah, because we're on the phone now, but sweet. As soon as you go.
On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet cove of Cork. We were sailing away with the cargo of bricks for the grand city hall in New York. She was a wonderful craft, she was rigged for a nap. Oh, how the wild winds drove her. She stood several glass, she had 27 masts, and they called her the Irish Rover. We had 1 million bales of the best slag of rags. We had 2 million barrels of gold. We had 3 million sides of a blind horse's hide. We had 4 million barrels of bone. We had 5 million hogs, 6 million dogs, 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million bales of old naughty goose tails in the hull of the Irish Rover. There was old Mickey Coop, who played hard on his flute while the ladies lined up for a set. He was tutored with skill for each sparkling quadrille, and the dancers were flutered and bet. With a smart woody talk, he was cock of the walk as he reveled the dames under and over. They all knew at a glance when he took up his dance that he sailed on the Irish Rover. There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee. There was Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, who was scared stiff of work, and a man from Whistlin called Malone. There was Snugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a roo, fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. And your man, Mick McGann, from the banks of the Van, was a skipper on the Irish Rover. When the measles broke out and the ship lost its way in the fog, and the whale of a crew was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's old dog. Then the ship struck a rock, oh Lord, what a shock, the boat it was turned right over. Turned 9 times around, and the poor old dog was drowned.
Two, three.
And the last of the Irish Rovers.